I have hairs everywhere. Of course I do. Because what else is new? No! Wrong button. Yeah, you know why, Susan? Because it's a book. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. No premiere today. I mentioned this in last week's Let's Talk Makeup, but there is no premiere today. And I think this is actually the last Let's Talk Makeup of this year. Because next week on Friday is Christmas. And I don't think that I will have the Let's Talk Makeup up then. I'm not planning to. So, yeah, I am planning a very short video. Am I planning a video, though? I actually have not. My planner is downstairs. Yes. So, I don't know if there will be a video next Friday. I think so, but I'm not sure. That is basically the household message. I'm kind of feeling a little bit nude today. I just didn't have the time to do my eyes this morning, or at least eyeshadow wise and all that. I just ran a little bit late, so I thought let's kind of do it like this, a little bit more, I don't know, nudie for me. So yeah, so falsies are from Primark, lippy is from Charlotte Tilbury, and that's, yeah, then I have some base makeup on, and then that is basically it. This video series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist and the community playlist are in my description box. The brands I will mention today are there as well. There are some discount codes there, and the sources that I use to make this video happen every day is there as well, along with my playlist of these videos, which will also be at the end screen. So yeah, let me just go to the side like that. Am I still in frame? Yes. And open up my Instagram. I have saved some fun things, I think. Or at least I think. Yeah, that's what I said. Some fun things, I think. Okay, let's just get into it, because usually these videos are longer. And the biatch to edit. But yeah, let's go to the first thing that I have here, which is from Yasmin's Glam Room. This is the full pink Candyland collection, and it is live on the website now. But as you are filming this, I don't know if it is still available. But I do think it is very cute. Now, you do get plastic packaging. It kind of reminds me of the plastic packaging from ColourPop. And then the outside is all festive and cutesy, and I like the way that this looks. Yeah, let's check out the eyeshadow palette as well. I don't know, is there a pressed glitter in there? Can I see that? Let's see if I can grab a better picture. Here I have a picture. I think there are glitters in here, but yeah, two pressed glitters are in here. So you get three mattes, three shimmers, two pressed glitters, and one duochrome. I do think that the color story is cute. I like the way that the outside looks. I like it. She also has nails, I believe, and lippies and falsies and all that. I will leave the website down below. I think this looks cute. Is it for me? Not. This is not really my kind of vibe. Well, if she had bats and skulls on the outside of the palette, it would be my vibe. It doesn't matter if they would have been pink or not, but yeah. But I don't know, for the holidays, you know, for someone who is into this, maybe it's fun. I the pressed glitters, that's, yeah, what I wish brands would stop putting pressed glitters into eyeshadow palettes. But that is me personally. I know that there are a lot of people who do like pressed glitters. For me though, yeah, I just wish that they wouldn't. That's basically it. But I do like the way that this looks. So yeah, I will leave the information down below. Let me know what you think of it. Okay, let's next go to Creative Soul Cosmetics, because this is their Vintage Holiday. No! Wrong button. Vintage Holiday palette. The stunning 1950s inspired palette, perfect for the holiday season. It includes three glitters, nine mattes, and nine shimmers. Again, glitters. I wish brands would stop with that. But yeah, it is a bigger palette. But still, it is. If I don't know the brand, if I'm not invested in the brand, it is almost a no-no for me. Unless I really, really like the color story. And then if it is a larger palette, or maybe has just one pressed glitters, I can kind of look past it. That was what I was looking for. But for me, this, while I do really like the color scheme of this, yeah, the three pressed glitters are then, yeah, that could be a deal breaker for me. But again, that is me personally. I just don't use them. You know? So yeah, but let me know what you think down below. I do like the way that it looks. It's a limited edition. It's available now. Order by today, December the 18th, for guaranteed delivery by Christmas. So, and I'm guessing that is in the US. Just saying, because yeah, I don't think they can do that internationally. But let me know if you have tried the brand. I think my friend Leora has, but I'm not sure actually. I don't know. I do like the way that this looks. That this is looking. It's difficult to speak today, apparently. But yeah, let's go next to Spoiled Lips Cosmetics. Yes, Spoiled Lips Cosmetics. I have a few things from them. Let's start with the travel collection, because these, you see here, picture of four eyeshadow palettes in total. Let's see, the one with the blue in the middle. Let's start with that. Meet Girls, Night and Romantic Getaway. That's the names of those two palettes. And then the other two ones, which are the warmer, well, basically the orangey one and the one with the bluey purpley thingamajingy, are Meet... oh. Wow. They are not called Meet Girls Night, but it is Girls Night. Yes, I said it was one of those days. But yeah, so the top picture is Girls Night and Romantic Getaway. The bottom picture is Day Trip and Tropical Traveler. I think there are just mattes and shimmers in here. I'm guessing. I actually don't know when they will be released. Let's see if I can find out, because I thought I had a little bit more information. 2 days. It's Wednesday today, so I'm guessing it goes live today or tomorrow. Yes, it will be a mini launch to have some available for under the tree, but the grand launch will be in January. So basically this is a mini pre-order sale thing then, I'm guessing. Limited quantities will probably be available, and it is again either launching today or tomorrow. I think it's today, but I'm not sure. I will leave their site down below though. The next thing that I had was this, which is Volume 19. Is it called Nevermore? Volume 19? I don't know. But this will be available for individual purchase mid-January. I kind of like this color scheme, guys. I think it is nice, and it's a softer color scheme with a few darker shades in there. A little bit dusty. I like it. Yeah, mid-January it will be available. And I heard that from Spoiled Lips, especially the one with the lips on the palette, those are good quality. That's what I heard. I have not tried the brand. I do want to though, because I think that they have a very cute aesthetic, and there are some palettes that I really like from them. So yeah, let me know if you have tried them and if you are excited about these releases. Next, we are going to go to Double Down Cosmetics. This is a new brand for me. Go away. Yeah, it's a new brand for me. They have a bunch of things. You see, I think swatches. Yeah, probably. Swatches and a stack. And basically, this is an eyeshadow stackables. It retails at 20, but I actually don't know if this is per stack or if it is per shade. I hope it's per stack, because per shade, yeah, that's pretty hefty. I do like the thought of this. I like it. And I like the color scheme as well. I don't know the brand. Maybe you do. Let me know down below. I think it's fun. Yeah. Okay, let's next go then to... Oh, what do I have next? Oh yeah, DJ's Unique Boutique. I really like her brand. Did you know, by the way, that the owner of the brand also has a YouTube channel? I will link her channel down below. Go follow her, because she's amazing. However, she has, besides two gorgeous eyeshadow palettes, she also has released a brush set. It's a 7-piece brush set. This looks very pretty. I'm not gonna lie. Oh, she also has lashes. Yeah, I forgot. Let's see. It's a brush set with some face brushes and some eye brushes, and it looks very, very sleek and very pretty. Do I know a price? I thought I saw somewhere a price, but I'm not sure. It doesn't say so. I think they're live already, and now that I'm on her feed, there are just her two other palettes are just so gorgeous. So yeah, definitely go check out DJ's Unique Boutique. I will leave her channel and her website down below. Let's next go to Indica Boutique. This is a picture of their All Things Must Pass eyeshadow palette. It's their second palette. 15 shades, 7 matte, 8 shimmers, a duochrome. So 7 shimmers and a duochrome. It's vegan and cruelty free. It's available from the 20th of this month. It will be $25. And it will kind of be a collection, so they will also have a scarf and some other goodies. So let's go to the palette. I think that the palette is pretty. It's not specifically for me, but I do like it. I like the color scheme. It's a little bit of a warmer neutral with a blue and a lavender and some, I don't know, some reds. Yeah, it is kind of this time of year, isn't it? I think the outside looks cute as well. Let me know if you have ever tried this brand and if you are excited. Okay, let's next go to Rebel Rouge Labs, because I have here... is this called... Yeah, Prelude to Agony. It's an eyeshadow palette. Let's see, from December the 15th to January the 10th is the pre-order window. Orders will ship to you late January, early February. There will be an estimated 15 to 20 business day production and processing window after pre-order closes on the 10th. If you order any ready-to-ship items with this pre-order, it will all ship together. That's basically what they are saying. So yeah, let's check out the shades, because there are no pressed glitters in here. You get five. And the reds are shimmers and such. I think that the color scheme is pretty. Yeah, I like it. It is a little bit, it is kind of something different with the one, the blueies and then the reds, the pinks and then the yellow and then the browns. I think it is something different, but I do think it's cute. I have never tried Rebel Rouge Labs before. I do want to. I have them on my radar. Oh, wait, I have prices. The pre-order price discount is $30. After the pre-order window closes, it will retail for $35. Let me know if you have ever tried Rebel Rouge Labs. I think this looks cute. I think this looks different. Yeah, let me know down below. Okay, let's next go to Lethal Cosmetics, because they have come out with gift bundles. So you see, I don't know how I have done it, but they have three bundles. So the first one is the Glam Kit one, is the shades Vertigo, Imago, Kindlewood and Symbiosis. It retails for $23.10. Yeah, so... I don't know the euro. Usually they are a German brand, so usually you get euro prices. I will just kind of round it out. So let's say it's $23. That is the four shades. Then you get the Glam Kit number two is Isotope Highlighter and Anemia Liquid Lipstick. Retails for around $34. Yes. And then the last one is Transient Liquid Lipstick, Face Gel Liner, Cascade, Mainframe, Unity and Synth, and that retails for around $75. I have Synth, haven't, don't I? Let's see.
Do I not have Synth already? Or is Synth? Yeah, I think I have Synth. Because now that I'm here, I have Synth. And I have Mainframe. Do I also have Unity? I'm kind of checking to see if I have the shades of the last set, because that's actually very pretty. I think I have... two shades, Unity and Synth. Mainframe, do I have Mainframe? Oh, Mainframe I have as well. Oh, so I have Mainframe and Synth. Unity I don't see here. No.
So yeah, unfortunately I already have two of the shades. Otherwise, because I needed to check, because I was actually very interested in this bundle. But I already have two of the eyeshadows. So yeah, then it's kind of... Then it is basically not for me. But I do think that it is very fun that they are doing bundles like this. And not specifically for the holidays. I like it. So yeah, I will leave their site down below. I need to film one more look with this one, the Velvet Dusk palette. And yeah, it's very, very nice palette. Let me just say that. I love their quality. Okay, let's go next to ColourPop. Because I'm basically a day late filming this video, I have a new ColourPop release. So yeah, this is the wine only collection. It's inspired by your favorite reds, burgundies and delish deep shades. It consists of a palette, 3 Super Shock Cheek and 2 Super Shock Shadows, a liquid liner, a Sol Shimmering Oil. And it dropped yesterday for you. I'm kind of feeling like ColourPop is duping itself a lot. Which isn't weird with all the releases that they are coming out with. I do think that this is a nice release for kind of for this time of year. Because of the burgundy tones. I kind of do like the tones that are in here. Not gonna lie. I also have swatches, so let me check out the swatches and save them so I can show them to you. If you want to see ColourPop swatches, go to Amanda's channel, Makeup Just For Fun. I will link it down below because she swatches all the new ColourPop releases. Just saying. I do like the color scheme of this though. Yeah, I like the color scheme of this a lot actually. So yeah, that's it. I like the color scheme of this a lot. The Super Shock Cheeks, I also kind of interested in. I have a Super Shock Cheek here and I really like the formula. That one is too light for me in summer though. But I do like the Super Shock Cheek formula. So yeah, I don't think I will get it, but it is pretty. Let's go to Badass Beauty next. You see here an eyeshadow palette. It is called the Strong and Beautiful, I think. Oh, MRE eyeshadow palette. Yeah, Strong and Beautiful. So Magnificent, Radiant and Elite. The price is $22. It is currently sold out, but it is available for pre-order. So I will link it down below. I do like the color scheme. Is it a rainbow palette? Yeah. Do I have this color scheme? Yeah. But I do still like it. I don't know. I like the vibe. I like it. That's basically it. I like it. I don't know the quality though. If you have tried this brand, let me know. But I will leave the site down in the description box. Let's next go to Pretty Hearts Cosmetics. Didn't I already have it? No. This is the Holiday Spell Collection, I think. I don't really know what the palettes are called. But yeah, it's a collection. There are 2 palettes and they are very, very pretty. They are pink. Pinks like this are for me more not specific. I do like my pinks now, but maybe a little bit more of the, again, the gray toned dusty pinks is what I'm gravitating towards now. These pinks I grab more towards February. I don't know why. The bluey one, yeah, I kind of like the colors. I know that one speaks to me more actually than the pinky one. I think they are very cute. And there's also, what is it? Necklaces, wow. And lip piece, wow, that was so bad. But yeah, let me know if you have ever tried the brand and how the quality is. Are you excited about this? I think this looks cute. The next one that I'm going to mention is Glamfice Cosmetics, and they have released 2 new liners, I believe. 2 new gel liners, Galactic and Celestial. They are duochrome retro liners and it launches today. And they look very, very pretty. Not gonna lie. Did I not have swatches? Yes, I did. No. Thank you. I have swatches here, so let me save this post. It looks very pretty. And the nice thing about that is that you don't have to mix it anymore. If you have something like this in a powder form, you have to mix it yourself. But you don't have to now. I think that the colors are very, very pretty. I have never tried the brand. I have no idea if these liners are good. If you have tried them, let me know. Because, yeah, it looks very, very cutesy. Okay, let's next go to Millennial Beauty. Millennial Beauty. They have a new cookies infused. No. cookies palette, infused hemp. Yes, mattes and shimmers. It retails for $25. It's available for a limited time. Yeah, click the link in bio to shop. So I don't know the price. If I look at the color scheme, it does not scream cookies to me. Per se. I know that you can decorate your cookies with different type of frosting, but yeah, I don't know. I would have. It would have made a little bit more, and that's maybe weird coming from me, but it would have made more sense to me if there were some more neutral shades in there, so some more brown shades, and then some, I don't know, what do you ice your cookies with usually? White, I think, especially this time of year, so a shimmer white, and then maybe a shimmer red, and you know, those kinds of, that you basically have your cookie shades, and then your frostings are in the sparkly bits, you know? That is... makes a lot of sense for me. I do think that the color scheme is cute, but yeah, let me know what you think down below. I don't know the brand. Do you know the brand? Have you tried anything from the brand? I like it. I like the fact that I have found some new brands this week. Then let's go to Storybook Cosmetics. Storybook Cosmetics is a brand that has my interest for quite some time, but they are also a little bit wonky with releases and with sneak peeks. This is a palette that has been sneak peeked, I believe, for 3 years. And it has finally arrived. And it is the Van Gogh palette. Now, if you don't know, Van Gogh was a Dutch painter. So let me pronounce it in Dutch. Just for funsies. We say Van Gogh. That's what we say. So yeah, I do like this palette, actually. Or I liked it a little bit more. The first time that they released, I liked it a little bit more, because what have they done? They say here, we've heard your packaging feedback. Goal is to have their palettes look and feel like books. So yeah, then what does that entail? The brand is specifically does that, Storybook. It is in the name of the brand. People are then still complaining, your packaging is too bulky. Yeah, you know why, Susan? Because it's a book. So yeah, but basically, because everyone's complaining about it, they have made a drawer that can fit brushes, mascara, eyeliner, etc. The only time that I think that is a good idea is if you are going traveling and you want to bring this palette, so you have extra storing room. You know, I could see another. Let me give you another option. When I film, I have a basket. I have a basket here with the stuff that I have on my face for me to easy, you know, refer to that. I could see myself doing that with this palette. If I were to have this palette, that I can basically, if I'm doing, for instance, a multiple looks video, so basically a shop my stash type of thing with the base products, I can fit them all underneath there. But otherwise, why? Don't do that. You know, if people are complaining that your packaging is too bulky, that's kind of their thing in this case. You know, it's their aesthetic. The book form is their aesthetic. Could they make the books maybe a little bit thinner? Yeah, maybe. But it is their aesthetic. So if you buy from this brand, then don't go and complain that their palettes are too bulky. You know? I do like the color scheme of this one though. And I was actually pretty tempted. I know blues are not my most used colors, but still, I don't know, it's also a little bit of nostalgia. You know, Van Gogh was a Dutch painter. He was raving lunatic as well, but it's probably because of all the paint fumes. And I like the painting, The Starry Night. So I was kind of like, ooh, I kind of like this. But now with the drawer, I don't know, I feel almost like it cheapens the palette. Does that make any sense? So yeah, I wish they wouldn't have done that, but I do really like this palette, actually. I think it is, I don't know, I have here a bookcase where I store my palettes in. I don't know, I like libraries. I like, that is one of the reasons that I like their aesthetic so much, because then you have them all as books. I think that's freaking awesome. So yeah, it is on sale now. Through their website. I don't know what it retails for though. And I'm kind of curious. I like the color scheme, guys. I like it a lot. Maybe it is not a very popular makeup opinion, but I do really still want to try the brand. But now I also kind of want to know what it retails for. Wow. Okay, so it retails for $60. Wow. Yeah, that is pretty. Maybe I will wait to. That's way too expensive for me, guys. If I see here their Mean Girl palette, oh, the Burn Book was 55 to begin with. It's on sale now, which is also very cute. Yeah, no, for that price, I will have to pay shipping. I will have to pay import tax because it's not sold, I believe, here in Europe. Yeah, unfortunately, it's a little bit too hefty of a price for me, which is a shame because I would have loved to try this palette. So Storybook Co Cosmetics, if you watch this, I would love to be on your PR list. Just saying. Just throwing it out there. I would love to own this palette actually. But yeah, unfortunately, not right now. Price-wise. Yes, let's next go to Rebellious Unicorn Cosmetics. This is their Slay Queen collection. It is online already. I like the color story of this. That is why I wanted to mention it. I really like, you will see the swatches as well. I really like the color scheme of this. Especially the, I don't know, the combination between the gray and the pink, and then a little bit of yellow and green. The only thing that I'm kind of missing, because I love to pair that with dark gray, is a red shimmer. But I do really like this color story. I like it a lot. Let me know how you like it. Maybe you have even tried it. Let me know down below. Let's next go to Solo Giovanni Cosmetics or Beauty. They have two new eyeshadow palettes. They retail for $30 each. They're available on the website. You see. Oh, okay. So Luring is the one with the white palette. Yeah. It's a warm and cool shade containing shimmers, mattes, and pressed glitters. Unfortunately, the other one also has pressed glitters, so I'm very sad about that because I actually really liked the color story of Luring. I really like that one. That immediately grabbed my attention because I love orange and teal, or aqua, I don't know. I love it. But the fact that there are glitters in here, yeah, it again makes me not want to try the palette. The other palette I really like the color story of as well, but I think there are even more pressed glitters in there. It looks to be three pressed glitters in the Alexandrite palette and one in the Luring palette, but I am not sure. But yeah, that's kind of a shame in my book. You know, my opinion. But I again do know that a lot of you really, really like pressed glitters. So yeah, let me know if you know the brand, if you have tried the brand, and all that goodness. Okay, let's next go to. Oh yeah, let's go to this palette. Now, I have actually mentioned this palette a few weeks back from Dazzle Me Dead. This is the Medusa from their Morphe Mini palette range. But I also know that a lot of you are kind of on the hunt for a green palette, and I thought let me throw this one in there as well. It's $27, and I really like the color story of this, so I wanted to show it to you because maybe you have forgotten about this palette, or maybe you missed the episode. I like it, so I will leave it down below. And then I'm going to go to a sneak peek from Menagerie Cosmetics, but also an update. So here you see a sneak peek of what's coming in 2021. Well, there's a bat on there because you see the bat wings. You see plums, I think they are. I love bats so much. However, what I wanted to tell you about is that next year there will be international shipping again. That is for me very, very nice. And yeah, for most people, very, very nice. But I just wanted to let you guys know that this one, Artistry Pur. I think Artistry Pressed Pigment Palette. I don't know if this will be an eyeshadow. I kind of hope this will be an eyeshadow palette and not a blush palette, because I don't like overly pigmented blushes, and I know that their blushes are very pigmented. But this was so cool if this was an eyeshadow palette. Fruit bat eyeshadow palette. Ooh, yes. But anyway, so they will start shipping internationally again next year, which is good for us. Okay, the last thing that I have is from VE Cosmetics. No, it's not the last thing, but because I want to mention something else as well. I hope I won't forget. Let's go to this from VE Cosmetics. I forgot to mention this a few weeks back, but she has also launched falsies, and they are in a coffin-shaped box. Very, very cutesy. That's what I wanted to say. That's what I wanted to say. I forgot to mention it last time. So yeah, I will leave their site down below. The last thing that I'm going to mention is, let me look it up. Because that's also something that I forgot to mention last time or a few weeks back. Okay, so let's go to 5050 Makeup. They have, I think I mentioned that they were going to revamp their Desert palette. Did I mention that? I don't remember. I thought I did, but I could also have dreamt it, because that is how it is in my mind sometimes. Basically, they have brought back the revamped Desert. It was supposed to be limited edition, but I guess the demands were high and a lot of people are very interested. So they brought it back and it is permanent. Why do I not have a picture? I know I have a picture. Maybe it is in my... God damn it, I know I have a picture. Oh, here it is. Restock alert. Yeah, the revamped... Oh, I actually reposted it on my Instagram feed. But I do have a picture that I will pull from the website, I believe. But it is their revamped... I said that four times, I believe. It's their revamped Desert palette without the press glitters. It's also bigger. I really like this color story a lot. Now, I have been asked to review this and I will. I really like this color story. I don't know. I really like it. I kind of hope that they will revamp their Aphrodite palette then too. Maybe for, I don't know, February next year? Pinky tones? I don't know. I'm just throwing it out there. So yeah, that was it for today, I believe. Yes, that was it for today. Yeah, again, no premiere today. I know some of you are very sad. I'm sad as well, because I do like to do premieres, but I think I wanted to do a live somewhere, or maybe I will just throw in a premiere on another video. Maybe I will just, I don't know, film a lengthy Get Ready With Me and make that a premiere so we can kind of chat at the same time. I haven't decided yet. But yeah, that is it for today. The brands that I have mentioned will be listed down in the description box. I am going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. And... yeah, as I said, next week, no Let's Talk Makeup, because it will be Christmas Day, yes. And then that is basically it, yeah, for today's video and all the announcements and all that jazz. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Before you leave, don't forget to leave me a comment down below as well, because it helps me out tremendously. And hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already, of course, because I would love to have you as part of my nest family, links, thingamajingies, bats, ooh, fruit bats, I don't know. If you have made it this far, give me a bat emoji. Just for funsies. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.